I created a new map for Ravenfield using photogrammetry. I walked around sculptures outside, entire parks, but also around small objects I found at home. The display.land app turned them into 3D models. The app opened my eyes. For the first time in my life, turning an object from the real world into a 3D model in a game was not a project that I needed to plan, worry about, and ultimately failed to find the time and motivation for. Instead, I just point the camera at something, walk around it, let the app upload the recording to their server, and after a bit of time I can go check whether it worked out. I have tried using photogrammetry a long time ago, and while it was cool to play around with, having to deal with the processing on desktop PC was incredibly time-consuming. Back then it was so tedious it didn't just slow down my work, no. Instead I just stopped using it completely. With display.land all the processing happens server-side. This means your computer is not blocked for hours calculating a 3D model. And as most of you should know, making a useful task radically more convenient does not just save time, it can completely change the way people work. This is what might happen here. I created a bunch of models with display.land. While cleaning them up, it was incredibly liberating not to have to worry about proportions in 3D space, and even texturing at first. Photogrammetry doesn't start with the demand create something from nothing, because that is what it feels like when the task is create a shape from 2D pictures. Instead, the starting point is, here is a high-poly, probably too detailed 3D model, cut off what you don't like and try to optimize the rest. Let's take a close look at the things that I made. My first asset that I ended up using was this big outside plant pot. It is the result of overusing the decimate modifier, and I was not happy with it at first. But when I tried to rebuild it from scratch, I realized just how ugly a box with textures was. The decimated version of a display.land scan was so much more alive, even though it's just a static object. I tried scanning a train station, thinking I could use it as a platform environment. I must have messed up that one badly. But in the end, I decided to still use the textures for roads and bridges. The park stairs and path model was a funny scan. I walked the path up in one direction and then returned, but the lighting must have confused the scan. I ended up with two paths. I cut off one and also created multiple versions. Some with only the stairs, one with only the path. By the way, I was using one of the oldest supported phones. I'm told newer ones perform better. Optimizing the models took a lot of time for me at first, but every session I learned so much to improve the process. I finally started using seams properly and learned to create them efficiently. I discovered how to rebake UV maps. I found alternatives to the cool but limited decimate modifier, specifically dissolving vertices and faces. This scan of a Roman garden kind of thing didn't work out. I wanted to use it but messed up the sequence of things and replaced the old UV map before baking. I decided to just rebuild the shape using cubes and simple scaled and tiling textures. The result looks so unnatural, a reminder of better sticking to the scan meshes. Once plants had thicker leafage, their scans became easy to make. You might have noticed the obelisk plastered all over the level. It breaks up lines of sight very nicely. Obviously, this map is supposed to be somewhat surreal. I used a decimated version at first, which looked quite messy. Later, I took the time to clean it up, primarily using face and vertice dissolves. This stone gate was surprisingly low poly from the initial scan to begin with. I scanned it in bad light conditions. The sun was quite strong, which means contrasting shadows. Yet it worked out nicely. This hand here is a 2-scale smartphone holder, also one of my favorite meshes in the map. At first, one model took me hours to clean up, but now I am able to finish simple meshes within minutes. My favorite part about this project was turning a statue into a character model and replacing the soldiers that would normally run around the map. I am no professional 3D artist. If anything, I'm a generalist. There's a lot of potential I haven't yet tapped, specifically baking normal maps. But especially for lo-fi aesthetics, this workflow is pretty much ready to go. You can use the display.land app for free on both iPhone and Android. If you do create something and want to share it with me and the other viewers, please leave a link. The comments will land in my moderation inbox because of the link, but I will approve them. And if you have Ravenfield installed, you can get my new map from the workshop now. Have fun with both or either. Until next time, ciao!